In the Red Rising trilogy, Pierce Brown throws us into a revolution concerning equality and truth. It is heavily violent but also sentimental as characters struggle to carve a place and identity in the rapidly changing society. Now, a pitfall I had when writing this video was confusing rebellion and revolution. Revolution is a fundamental and relatively sudden change in political power and political organisation, which occurs when the population revolts against the government, typically due to perceived oppression or political incompetence. Rebellion is a refusal of obedience or order. It refers to the open resistance against the orders of an established authority. Revolution and rebellion have different goals. Whilst a rebellion looks to gain concessions, a revolt aims to overthrow and destroy the oppressive power. In Red Rising, the revolutionary dynamic of oppression and resistance is explored through the society and Sons of Ares. The Sons of Ares aim to topple the colour system, which has been in place for 700 years. Unlike the Moon Lords, who are in rebellion, the Sons of Ares are attempting revolution, bringing down a corrupt empire. Pierce Brown is conscious of the need for intricacy when writing revolution. Even with a cause as just as Darrow's, Brown would be wrong to avoid questioning the morality of the Sun's actions. There is a thin line between terrorism and guerrilla warfare, and the Rising doesn't always fall on the right side of justice. Harmony in particular embodies this, with her group the Red Hand attacking civilians, without looking at the wider picture. Pierce Brown also explores the idea of ethical revolution, the idea that the world created after the violence has to be significantly better than the one before, that the result justifies the cost of warfare. Virginia in particular questions the ethics of the revolution, with the idea that she needs to see that Darrow can build as well as break. He needs to convince her both that the society is irredeemably broken, and also that he will usher in something better, rather than another dark age. When writing Rebellion, you also need to write the character of the revolutionary, the Toussaint Louverture, the George Washington, or Vladimir Lenin of the movement. The true revolutionary is guided by a great feeling of love. The revolutionary is a doomed man. He has severed every link with the social order and with the entire civilized world, with the laws, good manners, conventions, and morality of that world. He is its merciless enemy and continues to inhabit it with only one purpose, to destroy it. Both of these are largely true of Darrow, guided by love and conviction, but also existing to destroy the society. With Io's martyrdom, Darrow loses her to the cause of revolution. Darrow doesn't have ownership, even over his own physical body, which has been given by the cause. The revolutionary can easily lose touch with their identity, and through his monologues, the reader sees Darrow struggles to decide what he is behind the mask of the Reaper of Mars. Darrow's revolution is a violent one, and Pierce Brown attempts to justify this. We see this through the legacy of the Dancer Rebellion, Darrow's father's peaceful protest to attempt to increase food rations. But against the society, this form of unrest is proven useless, with Darrow suffering consequences firsthand. Darrow has no doubt that violence is a necessary tool, with this likely a result of his family's struggles. This goes without saying, but a revolution requires support, usually from the downtrodden masses. The Rising gains most support from the low colours, reds, oranges, browns, greens and blues, yet with the ruling gold so clearly above others in society, the Rising unites all the colours against the gold. Openly favouring one people is a surefire way to foster resentment, and it is important that society has these endemic flaws. A revolution narrative works best when the power they overthrow is already damaged. Darrow does this by causing civil war. The Sons of Ares can thus spread and draw more supporters to the cause. When writing revolution, an author needs to decide whose story to tell, whether the narrative is from the perspective of an innocent bystander, the instigator, or their adversary, the conflict will affect them. Darrow moves from the bystander to instigator, highlighting how the society is a victim of their own downfall, sparking Darrow to action. Pierce Brown tries to justify conflict by creating a dystopian solar system where revolution is necessary for the sake of humanity. In summary, a revolution novel needs these elements to thrive: an oppressive power and oppressed people, a leading revolutionary needs to ask questions about the morality of the revolution, also needs to consider whether it will focus on the revolutionary, a member of the status quo, or civilian. It needs to explore non-violent and violent forms of revolt, and most importantly, not lose touch with the characters. Characterization is what makes the reader interested in the revolution. Explore their reasons, motivations, and opinions, and you're well on track for an effective revolution novel. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that video. There'll be more Red Rising videos to come, as it's my favourite series. This one's scripted, so that's why there's no face cam today, apart from this scene here. Anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, subscribe. There'll be more videos like this. I'm going to read Mistborn, and I'm going to do a Why You Should Read or a review of that. So look out for that as well. And I will see you around. Goodbye.